What's up, guys and gals? It is I, once again, Yusuf El Sened, and welcome, guys and gals, to another episode of the Movie Monday series, which was created by Emily Boone, a fellow YouTuber and dear friend and family of yours truly. Please do check her channel out, the link of which will be down below in the description box. But for this episode in the Movie Monday series, yours truly will talk about and discuss five films. Four films actually, and one TV show, which have five cleaners or hitmen slash hitwomen, and these cleaners or professionals are the best hitmen and women who left quite an impression on yours truly. They did, which is no surprise whatsoever, since they are indeed professionals. This episode will include these gents and ladies, and they will be ranked accordingly based on a ranking system from number 5 to number 1, and here's how the list goes.
¿Qué es eso?
Number 5, we have Michael Ehrmantraut, or simply known as Mike from Breaking Bad. Breaking Bad is a damn good TV show, and Better Call Saul, I don't have much interest in seeing it, but eventually I will. And one of the reasons for that is because of Michael Ehrmantraut. Mike, guys and girls, is a hitman yours truly loves so much, and one of the reasons is because of his professionalism. And also the fact that he's a hitman, a cleaner with a heart of gold, and his intention is for the best, especially when it comes to his young granddaughter, his granddaughter who he loves so much and wants to provide for. Michael Ehrmantraut is a professional cleaner who does his job and gets paid with interest, and that's why he's included in my top 5 list at number 5. At number 4, we have Eris. Eris is a hitwoman from John Wick Chapter 2, a damn good movie, especially as an action slash thriller film. Eris is a damn great hitwoman who gives John Wick a fight, a damn good fight he would never forget, and I love the fact that she is mute and has quite a dark sense of humor and is also very kick-ass in the action department, and she is so awesome to watch, especially when she gives John Wick the finger, and I was like, fuck you too, bitch. But man, guys and girls, I love her dark sense of humor and quirk, especially as a hit woman who is a mute and basically tells John Wick and her employer to fuck off and gives that look like, I love that so much, especially in someone like Ruby Rose Langenheim, who was so great as Eris. She was, guys and gals, and that's why she ranks at number 4.
The only thing that didn't show up was the Polish cavalry. You're alive. I saved you. Do I get any thanks? No. All you can do is clam up. You wanna talk? You want me to fuck off?
Fuck off. You had to kill Fanning?
Who the fuck is Fanning?
Fanning, the cop. Why'd you have to kill him? He probably got family, kids that don't grow up without him. He believed me.
Oh, I should have saved him because he believed you.
Not that.
Yeah, that.
Yeah, that. What's wrong with that?
That's what I do for a living.
Some living. Why didn't you just kill me and get another cab driver?
Because you're good. We're in this together. Fates intertwined, cosmic coincidence, you know?
You're full of shit.
All that crap. I'm full of shit. You're a monument of it. You even bullshitted yourself. All I am is taking out the garbage, killing bad people.
Well, that's what you said.
You believe me?
Then what'd they do?
How do I know, you know? Look at that. Witness for the prosecution looked to me. Probably some major federal indictment of somebody who majorly does not want to get indicted.
So that's the reason.
That's the why. There's no reason. There's no good reason. There's no bad reason to live or to die.
Then what are you?
Indifferent. Millions of galaxies of hundreds of millions of stars and a speck on one in a blink. That's us, lost in space. A cop, you, me. Who notices?
What's with you?
As in?
As in, if somebody had a gun to your head and said, you gotta tell me what's going on with this person over here or I'm gonna kill you. What is driving him? What was he thinking? You know, you couldn't do it, could you? Because they would have to kill your ass because you don't know what anyone else is thinking. I think you're low, my brother, way low. Like, what were you, one of those institutionalized raised guys? Anybody home? And the standard parts that are supposed to be there and people in you aren't. Well, why would you kill me?
Well, Gabby's not letting I get back. Sigmund Freud meets Dr. Ruth.
At number 3, we have Vincent from Collateral, a damn good movie with Tom Cruise in the central role as Vincent, a damn good hitman, who is also efficient in what he does, and he has a very dark and morbid philosophy on life, which is so twisted, yet he believes in it wholeheartedly. And Vincent also makes the life of Max, Jamie Foxx's character, a living nightmare. Max, of who is a cab driver, but Max, he changes over the course of the film from a man who was so meek and naive into becoming someone who is strong and hardened, and it's because of Vincent and his sick, twisted philosophy on life. But Vincent is so efficient at his job regardless, and that's why he ranks at number 3.
Just for today.
Uh-huh. So it's safe to say today's your last day in town and we'll never see your fat fuck.
At number 2, we have Leon Montana from Leon the Professional, or simply known as The Professional. And this movie is so great and so awesome and so heartfelt, and has a young girl in Matilda, and little Matilda learns a great deal from the cleaner himself, Leon Montana, who yours truly loves so much. Leon Montana was brought to life by Jean Reno, and that's why he ranks at number 2. And finally, guys and gals, at number one, we have the fucking operator from The Night Comes for Us. And this movie is a 2018 Indonesian action slash drama, which yours truly loved so fucking much. This movie was so great and so awesome. It was, and one of the reasons behind it is because of Julie Estelle's character, the operator, or as yours truly called her, the fucking operator, who is so awesome and so killer in what she does. This woman kicked the ass of the main character of this film, Ito, and I was like, what the fucking hell? The operator was so badass, but damn, she owned him. She was so great and so awesome and fought two women, two other killers, and she kicked their asses single-handedly, and it was so awesome and so fucking badass. She cut them to bits, literally, she did, and it was so awesome and so glorious. All of these hitmen and hitwomen, the cleaners or professionals, were, one more time, guys and gals, one more time, glorious. But yeah, guys and gals, that was my top 5 list of cleaners or hitmen slash hitwomen. Thank you guys and gals for watching. Hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please like, comment, subscribe if you wish. And once again, do check out Emily Boone's channel, the link of which I'll add down below in the description box. But thank you all once again. And until next time, peace out, take care, adios amigos, au revoir, and sayonara.